What's up, everyone? Chris from PickDogs.com here with your free Major League Baseball home run prop show for Friday, June 23rd, 2023. Now, just a reminder, if you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed to our channel and smash that thumbs up. It helps us out a ton. And we will get into the home run prop action momentarily, but we'll do a recap of the plays we gave out yesterday. Had a nice day with the home run props, managed to hit a few, managed to make some nice plus money so we can roll it over into today's action. Now, before we proceed, I want to just remind everybody, these plays are very high risk, high reward. They are not meant to be plays that I recommend you dump your whole bankroll into. They're just plays for some fun, for some side action, to have some pizza money or some coffee money on the side. But other than that, you know, like I said, they're not plays that, you know, you're going to build a huge, huge bankroll with. Or at least I don't recommend anybody try to do it that way. If you hit a nice parlay, then, you know, hey, all the power to you. You don't have to play every single play that I give out here. These are just the angles that I am looking at, the plays that I will likely have a couple of bucks on any day's action. For today, it's going to be obviously Friday's action. And I know some people do like to parlay these plays up as well. So any plays that you do parlay from here, what I recommend is if you're playing a parlay three legs or more, I recommend a round robin. It will drive up the cost of the bet a little bit, but it's also going to give you a safety net in case one of the legs or more, depending on how many legs of the parlay you play and how many combinations you combine the round robin by. But it'll give you a safety net in case something goes awry. So it's definitely worth looking into. How many times have all of us had that parlay that was busted up by one leg that you know, could have at least cashed something if we had put a couple extra bucks down and had a round robin going? So that's my recommendation for the home run props. But we'll take a look at the props that we did hit on Thursday. I went to that matchup between the Braves and the Phillies, and I'll tell you, it was a pitcher's duel through nine innings. But hey, better late than never. Marcell Ozuna coming through for us at plus 400 with that home run in extra innings. We also caught Lane Thomas at plus 600. Like I said, he usually might go-to against left-handed pitching. He did come through for us there. Also, Ketel Marte coming through in that Nationals and Diamondbacks matchup at plus 550. And we also hit Manny Machado at plus 475 in that matchup, that headliner matchup between the Giants and the Padres, a game that the Padres won handily in blowout fashion. But now we'll look at the home run props for Friday. And when we do, you know, we'll have a lot on the board. But I want to know, you know, what do you guys think of Friday's card? Do you like the angles I took on some of these games? Do you not like the angles? Do you have player props, home run props of your own? Drop them in the comment section below. Let me know. You know, sometimes I take a look at the comment section and pick out some of the home run props and put a couple bucks on the props that you guys give out, because some of those have been absolute fire. We made a ton of money as a community. But if you're going to do that, you know, I always say it, I implore everyone, please drop them in there before the games actually start. If they're not in there before the games start, they don't help anybody. And we're trying to beat the books as a team. One unit, one goal here at Pick Dogs, and that goal every single day, whether it's sides, totals, player props, you name it, is to crush the books every single day and make them pay us out. So let's get into the home run prop action for Friday. And we're going to start things off with the matchup between the Tigers and the Twins. And I'm going to go Tigers heavy in this one. Not something I normally do, but hey, you know, the Tigers are hitting righties well right now. And, you know, they're going up against Kenta Maeda. It's his first start back in 2 months. But I like Javier Baez for a home run here at plus 600. The Tigers hitting righties fairly well lately, including Baez, who is hitting 389 with three extra base hits, including a home run in the last week against right-handed pitching. So give me Javier Baez for a home run at plus 600. I'm also going to look at Matt Vierling for a home run at plus 750. He has two home runs in the last week against right-handed pitching. Both came against the Twins in the last series. He gets the nod here. I think Vierling's got a good shot at getting one in this one as well off of Maeda or potentially that Twins bullpen. So give me Matt Vierling for a home run at plus 750. I'm also going to look at Kerry Carpenter for a home run at plus 600. Again, playing really well since coming off the injured list a couple of weeks ago. He's batting 300 with four extra base hits in the last week against right-handed pitching. So give me Kerry Carpenter for a home run at plus 600. I was also considering Spencer Torkelson as well. He homered in the last series against the Twins himself, but he is hitting just 130 against right-handed pitching in the last week. I'm also interested to see if any of you guys like the Twins against lefty and Joey Wentz. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section if you have any Twins on the board in that game. But I'm going to look at this match between the Rays and the Royals. I'm going to go with Randy Arozarena for a home run at plus 340 here. One of the hotter Tampa Bay Rays right now. You know, he's hitting 474 with a pair of home runs against right-handed pitching in the last week. Zach Greinke, he's had a problem giving up home runs on the road since he joined the Royals. And against the Rosarena, I think he could have issues here as well. Give me Randy Rosarena for a home run at plus 340. I'm also going to take Isaac Paredes for a home run at plus 430. Same boat with Paredes here, who has a pair of home runs and a 438 batting average in the last week against right-handed pitching. So I'm going to take Isaac Paredes for a home run at plus 430. Now, I do think this is a catalog spot once again for the Atlanta Braves against Luke Weaver at Great American. There's a bunch of Braves that I am going to play here. These are all official plays for me. There's just so many of them that I don't want to put all the graphics up and then have everybody say, well, you're playing the whole Braves lineup. Well, no, I'm not playing the whole Braves lineup, but you know, Austin Riley, he has a pair of home runs against Luke Weaver in his career. He's going to get a play. Ronald Acuna Jr., Matt Olson, Ozzie Albies all have a pair of homers against righties in the last week. Eddie Rosario, he's got three against righties. So those are some of the names I'm going to play. Riley, Acuna Jr., Olson, Albies, Rosario. I don't think you go wrong with a single bat for the Braves against Luke Weaver. He's given up a 10.7% barrel rate this year. So that's my stance on the Atlanta Braves in that one. On the other side, we're going to go with Ellie De La Cruz for a home run at plus 360. Now, he's seeing the ball really well right now. You know, he's hitting .474 in the last week against right-handed pitching with four extra base hits, including a home run. A.J. Smith-Shawver, he's only making his third career start, and he just gave up two home runs against the Colorado Rockies. You know, it wasn't at Coors Field. It was actually in Atlanta. But still, you know, he moves to probably the most hitter-friendly environment he'll have played in to date. So I'm going to go with that Ellie De La Cruz for a home run at plus 360. I'm also going to look at Jake Fraley for a home run here at plus 525. Hitting .417 with a pair of home runs in the last week against right-handed pitching. So I'll take Jake Fraley for a homer for the Reds at plus 525. For the Miami Marlins, we're going to go with Garrett Cooper for a home run at plus 600. Now, Cooper, he had a clutch home run on Thursday. I like his chances of going yard again here. Hitting .333 with four extra base hits, including a pair of home runs in last week against right-handed pitching. Now, Luis Ortiz getting the start for the Pittsburgh Pirates here. He's been one of the worst pitchers in baseball for allowing hard contact this season. He's sitting in the bottom 4% of pitchers in exit velocity, bottom 5% in hard hit percentage, a 12.7% barrel rate allowed this year, while Garrett Cooper posting a 10.4% barrel rate at the plate this season. So give me Garrett Cooper for a home run at plus 600. And I'm also going to take a shot here with Luis Arraez at plus 1150. This is what I was talking about, you know, over the last week when I said that you normally get good prices with Arraez, mainly because a guy that he's been hitting for contact over the course of his, you know, 400 batting average chase this season. But in the last week against right-handed pitching, he is hitting .609 with a home run. So at this price, I think it's worth just putting a couple of bucks on and seeing if Arraez can come through. So give me Luis Arraez for a home run at plus 1150. And I'm also going to look at the couple of Orioles here against the Mariners. I'm going to look at Ryan O'Hearn for a home run at plus 475. You know, I like Logan Gilbert, you know, going back to last year, but I feel like he's taken a step back this season. In his last seven starts, he's a 4.85 ERA with a home run allowed in five of those six starts and seven home runs allowed in that six-start stretch. Now, Logan Gilbert's also allowed a 9.9% barrel rate this season, while O'Hearn a 13.2% barrel rate at the plate, also hitting .471 with a home run against right-handed pitching in the last week. So I'm going to take Ryan O'Hearn for a home run at plus 475. I'm also going to take Austin Hayes for a home run at plus 650. He's got 11.7% barrel rate this season, but he's also hitting .647 with four extra base hits, including a home run in the last week against righties. So give me Austin Hayes for a homer at plus 650. I'm also going to look at Gunnar Henderson for a home run at plus 510. Now, normally, I'm not jumping on guys with a .214 batting average in the last week against righties, but Henderson leads the Orioles in barrel rate right now at 13.7%. I think another run of home runs is coming for Henderson. I think it's going to be a good launching spot for him. Felt the same way about Nolan Arenado when he started Jack again. I think we could see the same here with Gunnar Henderson. So give me Gunnar Henderson for a home run at plus 510. Now, before we get into our last few home run props, I just want to remind everybody, obviously the purpose of this home run prop show is to put you guys on some free home run prop winners, but it's also to highlight the benefit of using the betting tools at Pick Dogs and Sports Chat Place. It's where we get the graphics for this betting tools, for the shows directly from the betting tools. You can see the player prop. You can see how often it hits. You can change sample size to 5 games, 10 games, you know, following a win, following a loss, home games, away games, the entire season, you name it. And You can also see how often those player props hit and which book is giving you the best possible price. You know, and the nice thing about that is if you don't have an account with the book that's giving you the best price, you click on that price, you get taken to that sports book. And you can also, if you're a new customer, you sign up for a bonus offer on us. And you get to play that price with that bonus while also adding to your advantage over the books that they can't take away from you, which is your ability to shop lines and find the best possible number. There's also other tools there. If you like betting hot and cold trends, there's a streaks tool. There's multiple parlay builders. There's profitable teams, profitable angles, you name it. They're all there for you to use at PickDogs and Sports Chat Plays. I could probably do a show every day for an hour just using those tools to pick out winners, but I think it's more effective if everyone, you know, goes over to PickDogs.com, SportsChatPlays.com, and checks out those betting tools for yourselves. But let's get into the rest of the home run props for Friday's action. We're going to the Texas Rangers here against the New York Yankees. We're going to go with Jonah Heim for a home run at plus 475. He leads the Rangers in home runs against righties in the last week with three. Also has an 8.7% barrel rate offensively this season. Clark Schmidt, the Yankees starter, has allowed a lot of hard contact and 8.8% barrel rate allowed as well this season. So give me Jonah Heim for a home run at plus 475. I'm also going to look at Corey Seager for a home run at plus 430. He's hitting 375 with five extra base hits against right-handed pitching in the last week. So I'm going to look at Corey Seager for a home run at plus 430. I'm also going to look at Adelis Garcia for a home run at plus 410. He's starting to heat up again at the plate. He's hitting 320 with three extra base hits, including a home run against right-handed pitching in the last week. So give me Adelis Garcia for a home run at plus 410. Now for the Toronto Blue Jays, I'm going to go with a stack here against the Oakland A's. And to start things off with Dalton Varsho at plus 380. Now he's hitting 263 in the last week against right-handed pitching, but he's also one of the best, if not the best, left-handed bat the Jays have this season. Now why is that big? Well, it's big here considering that the A's starter, James Caprillion, this season has allowed 8 home runs. 6 of those have come against left-handed bats. So give me Dalton Varsho for a home run at plus 380. I'm also going to look at Danny Jansen for a home run at plus 400. He's filled in nicely in a starting role right now for the Blue Jays behind the plate, hitting 313 with a pair of home runs in the last week against right-handed pitching. So give me Danny Jansen for a homer at plus 400. I'm also going to look at Matt Chapman at plus 350. He is hitting just 176 against righties in the last week, but he's always a power threat for Toronto as Chapman leads the Jays in barrel rate at 18.9%. He's also the lone active Blue Jay to have a home run off of James Caprillion. So give me Matt Chapman for a homer at plus 350. I'm also going to look at Bo Bichette for a home run at plus 575. He is still hitting 300 in the last week against righties with three extra base hits. And I say it whenever we back Bichette on this show, we usually get great value with Bichette, who is still among the league's best overall hitters. And what you see with Bichette is what you get home or away. He's hitting 7 home runs at home, 7 on the road this season. So it's pretty much universal across the board. Bichette just quality hitter across the board, and I think he could potentially get one here at a nice plus 575 payout. And we're going to go with the standalone play for the Angels here against the Rockies, and you guys should probably know who it is, Shohei Ohtani at plus 300. Now, Ohtani against a lefty is decent enough, hitting 286 with 3 home runs in the last 2 weeks against righties. But now we put Ohtani in Coors Field against a Rockies lefty and Kyle Freeland, who does have an 8% barrel rate this season. I think this could be a messy matchup for Freeland. I like Shohei Ohtani for a homer at plus 300. And our last game of the day, we're going to look at the San Diego Padres. We're going to go with a stack here, Padres against the Washington Nationals. We're going to go with Manny Machado for a home run at plus 410. Homered for us yesterday. He's hitting 357 with 3 home runs against left-handed pitching in the last 2 weeks. He's a career 389 with a home run in his career against Nationals starter Patrick Corbin. Now, Corbin, he's allowed a home run in 4 of his last 6 starts and 6 home runs in that stretch. And 5 home runs in that stretch have come on the road. Corbin's also allowed a lot of hard contact this season, an 8.3% barrel rate. So I'm going to take Manny Machado for a home run at plus 410. I'm also going to look at Gary Sanchez for a homer at plus 460. Sanchez has a homer in his career against Corbin. Does have a pair of home runs in the last 2 weeks against left-handed pitching. So give me Gary Sanchez for a home run at plus 460. And I'm going to round things out with Fernando Tatis Jr. at plus 245, our lowest plus money payout of the day. But hey, if it manages to come through, I'm not going to sneeze at plus 245 on the take back. He's hitting 333 with 4 extra base hits in the last 2 weeks against lefties. Think he could get Corbin here or maybe even get to that Nationals bullpen. So give me Fernando Tatis Jr. at plus 245. We'll do a quick recap of the plays that we gave out for Friday's action. We started things off in Detroit with the Tigers and Javier Baez at plus 600. Also went with Matt Vierling for the Tigers at plus 750. And Carey Carpenter at plus 600. Also considering Spencer Torkelson in that game as well. For the Tampa Bay Rays, went with Randy Arozarena at plus 340. And Isaac Paredes at plus 430. So if you want to know the catalog of spots I like for the Atlanta Braves, just head on back a little bit earlier in the show. Just a few minutes ago, we talked about it. The catalog, the stack of Braves I like in that one. Five Braves in total for Atlanta there. I'm also going to go with Ellie De La Cruz for the Reds at plus 360. And Jake Fraley at plus 525. For the Marlins, we're going to go with Garrett Cooper at plus 600. And Luis Arraez at plus 1150. For the Orioles, we're going to go with Ryan O'Hearn at plus 475. Austin Hayes at plus 650. And Gunnar Henderson at plus 510. For the Rangers, we're going to go with Jonah Heim at plus 475. Corey Seager at plus 430. And Adelis Garcia at plus 410. For the Blue Jays, going to roll with Dalton Varsho at plus 380. Danny Jansen at plus 400. Matt Chapman at plus 350. And Bo Bichette at plus 575. Standalone play for the Angels, we're going to go with Shohei Ohtani at plus 300. And for the Padres, round things out, Manny Machado at plus 410. Gary Sanchez at plus 460. And Fernando Tatis Jr. at plus 245. But thank you guys so much for watching. Appreciate each and every one of you. We're up over 133,000 subscribers here on our YouTube channel. Couldn't have done it without you guys' love and support. So thank you for that. And make sure that if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel and smash that thumbs up. It lets us know that you guys like this content. And it lets us know that you like what we're doing here at Pick Dogs. And it helps us out a bunch as well. Also, make sure you have notifications turned on so you can be the first to be in the know when the newest content drops here at Pick Dogs. We don't always have the luxury of purely primetime baseball like we do on Friday. Saturday, we'll have some afternoon action, so we'll try to get these videos out as early as possible. But there are times where sometimes we have to cut it a little bit close. I want to wait for information and some prices to come out on some of the guys I like. And it doesn't always leave a whole lot of time between when the video is released and first pitch. So if you have the notifications on, you get notified when the video comes in. And you can play those best possible prices as soon as the video drops. Also, if you're looking for my best bets, the games that I am most confident in, you can head on over to PickDogs.com. Click the Premium Picks tab at the top of the page. That includes my daily $19 best bet. And while you're at PickDogs Sports Chat Plays, I implore everyone, check out these betting tools. They're 100% free. They are there for you to use. They are a great asset to have in your back pocket when you're making your best bets for the day's action. They'll do the heavy lifting for you, and you're not going to find betting tools like this anywhere, period, especially for 100% free. So make sure you take advantage and check those out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys soon. Let's crush the books on Friday.